Radius, welcome to my YouTube channel. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Well, now I want to read some article about Voyager essay fits better payout over than VTX, set to return 270 million customers. The crypto lender will be allowed to return a portion of customer fund locked up at the Metropolitan Comerical Bank, which been frozen until now. The leverage crypto lender Voyager Digital Holdings says it has received a number of higher and better buyouts over than that offered by Alameda VTX Bank. In July, contrary to the investment firm's continued public statement, the company has also just been cleared to return 270 million in customer fund held in the Metropolitan Comerical Bank (MCB) by the judge presiding over its bankruptcy proceedings in New York. In a second day hearing presentation on Thursday, Voyager states that it has received words from as many as 88 interested parties keen to bail out the company from its financial loss, adding it is in active discussions with over 20 potentially interested parties. One of the most high-profile bids come from Alameda and FTX in July. Alameda has proposed to buy all of Voyager's assets and outstanding loans, expect the defaulted loan to 3 Euros Capital, then liquidates the assets and distributes funds in USD through the VTX US exchange. This was rejected by Voyager on July 25 on the grounds that it was not fully maximizing for its customer. The company also noted that it had already received leads from the marketing process that are higher and better than Alameda's FTX proposal. Contrary to alleged inaccurate public statement from Alameda's FTX, Voyager states that it has also separately sent Alameda's FTX a case and that is later regarding its inaccurate public statement confirming that Alameda VTX does not have a leg up on other bidders. 270 million in customer funds returned. News about other interested bidders comes at the same time that U.S. bankruptcy court judge Michelle Wallace has given Voyager the all clear to return a portion of his customer fund deposits. According to a Today report from the Wall Street Journal, Wallace stated the Voyager had profited a sufficient basis for its claim the customer sold and granted access to the custodial account held at the Metropolitan Commercial Bank, which is understood to hold 270 million in cash. Voyager had funds stated in the account at the bank when it filed for bankruptcy on July 5. Those funds were frozen when bankruptcy proceedings began. Voyager Digital CEO Stephen Ashley mentioned in July that it intended to restore customer funds from MCB as soon as a reconciliation and fraud prevention process was completed, and the firm reportedly asked to help the fund in the MCB releases on July 15. FOIA gross debts amount to some no greater than $10 billion from roughly 100. Okay, maybe just enough. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe.